Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Saurabh Mani Tripathi and you are watching my YouTube channel, Double E Lectures. The topic of this short lecture is Direct Current Machines, Power Flow Separation Diagram and Efficiency. In my preceding video lecture, I told you that it is impossible to convert 100% of the input power into the output since various losses occur in different components of the DC machine. Essentially, the input power must always be equal to the output power plus the losses occurring in the DC machine. In this short lecture, I am going to discuss the power flow separation diagram for both DC generator and DC motor. Now, first of all, consider the case of DC generator. In DC generator, a mechanical input power is applied to the shaft of the machine. The mechanical input power is equal to the product of torque TSH at the generator shaft and mechanical speed omega m of the rotor. Since the DC machine is driven mechanically as a generator, there occurs certain rotational losses. These rotational losses occurring in the DC generator include mechanical losses, eddy current loss, and hysteresis loss. Now, after subtracting these rotational losses from the mechanical input power, what remains is represented as the net mechanical power, which is then converted to the electrical power by electromechanical energy conversion. Here, the net electrical power developed in the armature is equal to the product of generated EMF EG and the armature current IA. Furthermore, there occur some internal electrical losses also in the DC generator. These electrical losses occurring in the DC generator mainly include shunt field winding copper loss, armature circuit copper loss, and series field winding copper loss. Now, one may ask about the copper losses in interpole and compensating windings of the DC generator. Actually, the interpole and compensating windings of the DC machine are connected in series with the armature and thus they carry full armature current. So, it is worth noting that the copper losses in interpole and compensating windings must be included in the armature circuit copper losses. Likewise, the power losses due to brushes may also be added in the armature circuit copper losses. In addition, some stray losses may also occur in the loaded DC generator, but they cannot be easily accounted for. In small machines, the stray losses are mostly ignored. However, for large machines, the stray losses are generally considered to be 1% of the output power in total. Now, subtracting all the electrical losses occurring in the DC generator from the developed electrical power in the armature, one may finally have the net electrical output power, which is equal to the product of terminal voltage VT and the total current delivered to the load IL. It is worth remarkable here that the mechanical losses, eddy current loss, hysteresis loss, and shunt field winding copper loss always occur in the DC generator irrespective of the load conditions, hence do remain constant. These losses together are called constant losses. On the other hand, the series field winding copper loss and the armature circuit copper losses, including interpole winding copper loss, compensating winding copper loss, and brush contact loss, do increase as the load on the DC generator is increased. These losses together are called variable losses. Furthermore, you must notice that about that point where the energy conversion process takes place, the power flow separation diagram may be separated into two partitions. In first partition, the net mechanical power available for energy conversion process is obtained after subtracting the rotational losses from the input mechanical power applied to the DC generator. On the other hand, in second partition, the net electrical output power is obtained after subtracting the electrical losses from the electrical power developed in the armature of the DC generator. This way, the power flow separation diagram can be used as a means of analysis of DC generator efficiency. So let us now understand the efficiency of DC generator. In view of the first partition in the power flow separation diagram for DC generator, we may now define the mechanical efficiency of the DC generator using the equation efficiency is equal to input minus losses over input. We have mechanical efficiency is equal to input mechanical power minus rotational losses over input mechanical power. The term input mechanical power minus rotational losses is nothing but the electrical power developed in the armature, that is EGIA. So, the mechanical efficiency of the DC generator is rewritten as electrical power developed in the armature over input mechanical power. Now, in view of the second partition in the power flow separation diagram for DC generator, we may define the electrical efficiency of the DC generator using the alternate equation, efficiency is equal to output over output plus losses. So, we may define the electrical efficiency of the DC generator as net output electrical power over net output electrical power plus electrical losses. Here also, the term net output electrical power plus electrical losses is nothing but the electrical power developed in the armature, that is EGIA. So, the electrical efficiency of the DC generator is written as net output electrical power over electrical power developed in the armature. Multiplying these two efficiencies, we may determine the overall or commercial efficiency of the DC generator. Thus, the overall or commercial efficiency of the DC generator will be net output electrical power over input mechanical power. Now consider the case of DC motor, where an electrical input power is supplied to the terminals of the motor. The input electrical power is immediately reduced by certain electrical losses within the DC motor. These electrical losses mainly include series field winding copper loss, armature circuit copper losses, and shunt field winding copper loss. After subtracting these electrical losses from the input electrical power, what remains is represented as the net electrical power, which is converted to the mechanical power by electromechanical energy conversion. Here, the mechanical power developed by the armature is equal to the product of back EMF EB and the armature current IA. Further, there occur certain rotational losses in the DC motor. These rotational losses occurring in the DC motor include hysteresis loss, eddy current loss, and mechanical losses. Moreover, the loaded DC motor may also sustain some stray losses, but they cannot be easily accounted for. So, after subtracting all these rotational losses from the mechanical power developed by the armature, one may finally have the net mechanical output power, which is equal to the product of the torque TSH at the motor shaft and mechanical speed omega m of the rotor. As previously explained, the series field winding copper loss and armature circuit copper losses, including interpole winding copper loss, compensating winding copper loss, and brush contact loss, together are called the variable losses in the DC motor. On the other hand, the shunt field winding copper loss, hysteresis loss, eddy current loss, and mechanical losses together are called the constant losses in the DC motor. Moreover, in first partition of the power flow separation diagram, the net electrical power available for energy conversion process is obtained after subtracting the electrical losses from the input electrical power supplied to the DC motor. On the other hand, in second partition, the net mechanical output power is obtained after subtracting the rotational losses from the mechanical power developed by the armature of the DC motor. Efficiency of DC motor. In view of the first partition in the power flow separation diagram for DC motor, we may first define the electrical efficiency of the DC motor using the equation efficiency is equal to input minus losses over input. We have electrical efficiency is equal to input electrical power minus electrical losses over input electrical power. Here, the term input electrical power minus electrical losses is nothing but the mechanical power developed by the armature, that is EBIA. So, the electrical efficiency of the DC motor is written as mechanical power developed by the armature over input electrical power. Now, in view of the second partition in the power flow separation diagram for DC motor, we may define the mechanical efficiency of the DC motor using the alternate equation, efficiency is equal to output over output plus losses. We may write mechanical efficiency is equal to net output mechanical power over net output mechanical power plus rotational losses. Here also, the term net output mechanical power plus rotational losses is nothing but the mechanical power developed by the armature, that is EBIA. So, the mechanical efficiency of the DC motor is written as net output mechanical power over mechanical power developed by the armature. Multiplying these two efficiencies, we may determine the overall or commercial efficiency of the DC motor. Thus, the overall or commercial efficiency of the DC motor will be net output mechanical power over input electrical power. A detailed discussion on the overall efficiency calculations would be made in my next video lecture. So keep watching and do like this video and subscribe to my channel. Please don't forget to share your learning experiences on this short video lecture. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.